Around the World with MS World. I'm Dr. Daniel Kantor, and we're here celebrating the 30th anniversary of the Consortium of MS Centers. And that's why I'm so happy to be joined by a person who's used to anniversaries. This is the president-elect of the Consortium of MS Centers. Dr. Gary Cutter is a professor of biostatistics at UAB and also the director of the data set of NARCOMS, the NARCOMS data set. And we're going to hear a little bit more about NARCOMS, and NARCOMS is actually celebrating its 20th year anniversary. Some people at home may or may not be familiar with NARCOMS. What is NARCOMS?
NARCOMS stands for the North American Research Consortium on MS. It was established 20 years ago to develop patient-reported outcomes, so we got patient perspectives on what is going on with the disease and be a source of research that is different from what we do in clinical trials and what we often do in the clinical medicine where we collect data, trying to figure out what's going on, but more so from the patient perspective. So NARCOMS has been around since 1996. We started registering patients. We've had great volunteers that have really given of themselves for the community and of MS patients. And we've published nearly 100 papers on results that have influenced the scientific community to be focused on issues of mortality, to realize that there are mortality implications, to think about comorbidities, where we do have issues of cardiovascular disease and diabetes and other issues that occur that confound the problems in MS.
So MS isn't people's only problem, and so it's important to study that.
Absolutely, and because it's a chronic condition that has lifelong implications, knowing what happens over the course of MS, and now with the drug treatments that are available where people may or may not be living longer, we think they are, but we don't have any data, much data, I should say. We need to be thinking about what happens as individuals age with MS and how do we deal with not only their MS issues that evolve, but also their other chronic conditions.
Now, people back home may be used to research hearing that it's coming from on top, it's coming from the doctors, and they're doing all that. But here it's a little bit different. This data is actually patient data from patients themselves.
No, the patients are wonderful. We impose on them to fill out questionnaires twice a year. These are, 20, 30, 40 page questions that they take the time to fill out. They often make suggestions on what we should be studying, what we should be looking at. We had interest to look at marijuana use, and we did that. And we do it in a way that is private. We don't release any patient data to anybody. We don't give it to their physicians. They can get their own data if they want, but I mean, we are trying to collect information that is from the patient's point of view and allows them to have input into what it amounts or what it means to be a patient with MS and what are the things that bother them. You know, many times in clinical trials, we measure things that may not be important to the patient. Mm-hmm. They may be important in developing a drug or for approval or looking at side effects, but we also measure side effects. We measure hospitalization. We focus, sometimes we had a special focus on insurance. And with the changes from the American Affordability Care Act, we saw that this has had influence on MS patients, changing some patients because of changing prescription patterns, changing drugs because of that, stretching their drugs, and finding out what high proportion of individuals are actually subsidized by pharma.
Now, if somebody wants to learn more about NARCOMS, or either they have MS or their loved one has MS, is there a website that they can visit? What is the website?
www.narcoms.org. And you can register, you can participate as much or as little as you want. We love to have long-term. We have some people who've been in the registry for the full 20 years. Overall, we've registered over 38,000 MS patients. And we, routinely have 7,000 to 10,000 respond to our surveys. And I wouldn't say it's painless, because I think, we really respect the time it takes from the patients to take the time to give us this information. But we're trying to put it to good use. We've informed a lot of policy issues. You can see by the posters, we've done quite a bit with demonstrations of the data in the scientific domain. And we send a magazine called NARCOMS Now to everybody who participates. Do it, 4 times a year, and it's designed to give feedback to the patients. We don't give enough back to them for what they put into the registry.
Well, thank you so much. What else would you like to say to people out there? We have an opportunity to talk to people who have been involved in NARCOMS themselves. Many of our viewers have, of course, been NARCOMS volunteers.
I think the strongest thing I can say is thank you. They have been remarkable in their commitment to this project. We actually think we're making a difference. And it's because of them, and all I appreciate, and I think all of us who are involved, just appreciate their wonderful gift that they give to us.
Well, Dr. Gary Cutter, as always, thank you for joining us with MS World, and thank you back home.